UFOs have been a hot topic on many Twitter battles, but do UFOs exist for real? What if we were to tell you that not only do they exist, but humans have already made contact with them several times? At least, that's what the Russians claim to be true. From the Soviet Union to the modern-day USSR, Russians have some mind-blowing documented instances of UFO sightings and encounters. Welcome back to the channel, guys. We bring you yet another video filled with thrill and mystery. In this video, we'll try to expound upon Soviet claims of discovering aliens. But before we begin, hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notifications for future uploads. Back in July of 2009, the Kremlin declassified some of the secret Cold War-era Soviet war documents and took the world in disbelief and astonishment. These classified documents were not hiding some secret plans for starting a war or making a superbomb. Instead, they contained something much more mysterious and fearful. These documents had detailed records of a UFO encounter by a Soviet nuclear submarine in the South Pacific. But wait, why and how were these documents kept hidden from the general public for so long? The Soviet Union, a totalitarian regime, strictly controlled the media and the information given to the general public. This fascinating incident was kept secret for so long only to be made public some 20 years after the demise of the Soviet Union. Now, what did the submarine see that night in the Pacific? As the submarine was on its usual patrol in the depths of the ocean, the radar picked up some unknown and unidentified crafts. On closer inspection, the Soviet officers found that the signal was indicating a formation of multiple vessels. The radar signals pointed out a fleet of 6 underwater crafts. These objects were apparently a very ordered formation moving at an unprecedented speed. In the maritime industry, it's quite normal for craft to detect unknown cruisers in the sea. Still, the Russian commander on the submarine realized that this was different. What totally blew the Soviet personnel out of the water, so to speak, was the speed with which these crafts approached their sub. Keeping the formation rigid, it's recorded that the UFOs were approaching the Soviet ship at a striking speed of 265 miles per hour. An underwater craft of the time couldn't move at this speed, for sure. The Soviet commander ordered his personnel to arm the guns for firing and stand by for further orders. The nuclear-armed vessel had no option but to defend itself from these mysterious appearances. Not knowing the origin of this possible threat, the commander ordered a rapid surfacing of the ship to get the UFO's trajectory and avoid any possible confrontation. This is where the story gets even more thrilling and nerve-wracking. As the submarine approached the water surface, they lost the UFO signal for a split second. And then the impossible happened. The crew witnessed the crafts emerge from the water and fly into the unknown. No man-made watercraft is capable of taking flight in the air and swimming at a speed of 265 miles per hour. These objects were for sure out of this world. In this modern time, no human technology is yet able to perform such stunts, let alone back in the Cold War era. Now, you might get why such an incident was kept secret for so long from the general public. With the public declassification in 2009, many conspiracy theories sprouted up among the masses. Some questioned the intent of these UFOs moving deep under the Pacific Ocean. Were they visiting, trying to hide in plain sight, or something more alarming, like do these aliens live deep under the oceans of Earth? All these questions troubled the people and UFO enthusiasts. But the last concern of the aliens having some association with deep water is the most relevant here. The next sighting by the Soviets will build upon the assumptions that the aliens use deep-sea darkness for hiding. The ocean world of our planet is vast and majorly unexplored. Only 70% of the oceans are mapped and explored by humanity. The rest we don't know a lot about. Well, it very well could be hosting some out-of-the-world life forms. Another shocking UFO encounter dating back to the Soviet era happened right under the waters of Lake Baikal. In the year 1982, 7 divers went on an underwater exploration mission in the lake. Located in the Siberian region, just north of the Mongolian border, Lake Baikal is the world's deepest freshwater lake. The Russian Navy divers were on a mission to document the hidden secrets of what lies beneath the ice-covered lake. Little was known about the lake's habitat and living conditions. The lake's immense depth and the below-zero year-round temperatures made Baikal a highly unexplored region on the planet. The mission required the divers to go at least 126 meters deep into the lake. But to everyone's surprise, it wouldn't last that long. Just 50 meters under the lake, and the divers came to a sudden realization that they were not the only ones there. the divers were being watched. Not by fishes or sea creatures, but weird humanoids. Yeah, that's right. Aliens again deep under an unexplored water body. The divers reportedly saw humanoid creatures at very close distance to them. They were described to be wearing helmets on their heads. The divers explained the creatures having arms and limbs, very much like human beings. What happened next will blow your mind. The creature's strange sight prompted the divers to catch one of the humanoids to take it to the surface, because why not? But as they got closer to the creatures, trying to catch them, the alien species reacted violently. The divers experienced a sudden force, pushing them upwards on the surface of the water. The divers rapidly rose to the surface from the deep waters. The sudden change in the water pressure made them suffer through decompression. As a result of the mysterious force, three of the divers immediately died. The rest of the four were severely injured and barely survived. Well, what do we make of the death of the three divers? Were the creatures our enemies, or were they merely practicing self-defense? That can't be answered with certainty, but it's pretty clear they didn't retaliate until the divers tried to throw a net on them. Now, it's upon you to believe all these incidents, but as counterintuitive as they may sound, they could be very true. After all, these documents aren't from some children's fantasy novel, but classified Soviet government records. From the look of it, these occurrences indicate the existence of extraterrestrial creatures. Were they here all these years hiding in plain sight, or do they visit Earth from time to time? These questions remain to be answered, and we'll probably get some leads on these as we unravel more mysteries. We hope you found this video helpful and informative. If you liked it, drop us a like and share your thoughts below in the comments section. And make sure you press the subscribe button before you leave. And we'll see you next time.